Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to our social sanchar on a subject which I think touches each and everyone's lives. We are here to understand the hot topic of the day, the plastic ban. We are very fortunate to have with us the regulator and the implementer on the same platform. As V Citizen Action Network, which many of you will know, we work in the space of citizen engagement and bringing citizens closer to the government. The idea of the social sanchar is to get clarity and to understand what everyone is talking about today. We are going to keep it very short, in the sense, not the interaction, so don't worry. We have with us all of you who are here in the audience, and as some of you may know, our format is to reach out to our online audience as well. The idea is to decongest Mumbai, so we say interact with your government from wherever you are. So welcome to our online audience as well. The format will be thus, that we will be inviting Dr. Anbalagan, our member secretary of the Maharashtra Pollution Control Board, to give his opening remarks. Thereafter, the implementing agency, our Deputy Municipal Commissioner, Mrs. Nidhi Choudhari from MCGM, who will also give the perspectives from the implementation point of view. There are many queries, and vast queries, should I put it that way, of different kinds. We will try our best within the time constraint to answer as many questions as possible and bring about clarity to understand what the plastic ban is all about. Its restrictions, item-wise, and whereas the associations for manufacturers of plastics or others who are a body of their own, they have a way of interacting with the government much easier. But our major focus today is to address all the common citizens, the households, those who are asking the questions, students. And I must say that we are delighted to have the participation of school children all the way from Kandivili, that is the Pawar Public School. Thank you, children, for making the attempt to come here. We also have the Bhada School from VT. So there is a lot of different demography, I should say, who are here. We are very grateful and privileged also to have with us Mr. Ajit Kumar Jain, the Maharashtra Information Commissioner from Mumbai. And thank you, Mr. Jain, for being with us. You have been a great support. Our entire portal is founded in partnership with the Eurecofob, so we thank our founding partner. And we are very, very fortunate to have the Mahindra Group supporting this whole initiative as we welcome Mr. Anirban Ghosh, the Chief Sustainability Officer of the Mahindra Group. Thank you very much, Mr. Ghosh, for coming with your team. And I think your banner, your standee, makes a statement anyway. It is not made of plastic. That will bring a question about the flex banners. So, the lovely venue, our Royal Bombay Yacht Club, we thank on behalf of VCAN for being our venue partner, our video technology partner, April Broadcast, our technology partner, IT, Technolegion, which is based in Kolkata. Most important of all, again, the students who make our volunteering possible, our collaborating college, Jai Hind College. So, and all of you. We are all part of the same movement together. So without much ado, the format, as I was saying, post the opening remarks of the two speakers, then the floor will be open for questions. But before that, we will take 10 minutes for a certain amount of clarity as we go along. May I request my fellow trustee, Mr. Ranganathan, to kindly start the subject matter and also to introduce the speakers. Mr. Ranganathan, please. Your mic, please.
It is indeed a pleasure and delight to welcome Mr. Anbalagan, Member Secretary of the Maharashtra Pollution Control Board, to this edition of Social Sanchar on Banning the Plastic. I mean, I am really grateful to him that when I requested him he readily agreed, because over the last couple of months, so many citizens and so many organizations have been raising issues about the implications of plastic ban, what are its aspects which are not clear to them, and what are the consequences of certain things, whether by doing or not doing. So we are really grateful to you for having come. Mr. Anbalagan is a bachelor in veterinary science with post-graduation in dairy development from the internationally renowned Institute of Dairy Development in Karnal. And he is keenly interested in all environment matters. And he also has a special interest in capacity building among the officers in whatever organization is working. He has been the, in prior assignments have been, he has been collector Ahmednagar district, and before coming to the Maharashtra Pollution Control Board, he used to be the joint CEO of the MIDC. So he knows both sides of the story, the polluter and the regulator. And I am also grateful to welcome Ms. Nidhi Choudhari, and she also readily agreed, because people are asking the question that in Mumbai city, how is the ban going to be implemented? Then already reports have started coming that truck drivers are being fined and all. So when we requested her to participate in the discussion about the implementation aspects, she readily agreed, and we are really happy to welcome her. She is an MA in both rural development as well as public administration, and she has been the a senior manager in the Reserve Bank of India for the last 5 years, and she has been in the as the Deputy Municipal Commissioner Special in the Municipal Corporation of Greater Mumbai for the last year or so. So welcome for this program. And you know, this government of Maharashtra had issued two notifications. Firstly, issuing orders on the ban, and second notification extending the period by 3 months. Now, these are notifications which have come almost a year and a half after the notification issued by the Union Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change in March 2016 on disposal of plastic materials. Now, we really want to know as to how the linkages are being built between the two notifications. For instance, the Government of India orders talk about disposal of plastics. They have said within 1 year, each municipal corporation must make arrangements for segregation of waste. They must make arrangements for recycling of plastic waste collected by them. They must also make arrangements for promoting alternate use, such as using plastics which are discarded for road construction and so on. And all these they are supposed to implement within a period of 1 year, which means by March 2018 they are supposed to implement all this. So we want to know whether this is being done, and how are you linking it with the recent notification of the Government of Maharashtra. Then second question is, this order talks about banning various types of plastics. Now sometimes we find, even from places outside Maharashtra, we receive some parcels, letters come, invitations come. These are very often put in cling wrap paper and sent, so that in the rains and all it not damage. So what do we do with these things? If we receive them, are we violating the order on ban on plastics? This is an issue which has to be, I think, clarified. Then sometimes, you know, even books also when you buy, usually they come in cling wrap paper from the publisher. And most of us now are ordering things on Amazon or any of those e-tailers. So if it is coming in cling wrap, are we committing an offense? Then third point is in regard to the alternatives to plastic. If you say don't use plastic, what is the alternative? Somebody has said use paper bags. Now, is it environmentally a better option? Because a plastic bag you can use 100 times. Paper bag you can use once or twice. So you are using much more bag. And in that process, you may be cutting trees, you may also be polluting the environment. I remember in the 80s, in Government of Maharashtra, some officer in the Forest Department came with a proposal for minimizing the cutting down of trees. Stop using wood in government offices. Then what is the alternative? They said use plastic furniture, use iron furniture and all. Question is whether you are doing more damage by that alternative. And the amount of energy which is required in producing iron and steel and the environmental damaging, mining, etc. do, whether all these aspects have been considered. So with reference to plastics, if you are banning plastics, what are the other alternatives which are ecologically less damaging than use of plastics? Of course, ban on plastics has come in Maharashtra, I would say more or less at the opportune time, because all of you might have known that on the 5th of June, on the World Environment Day, the United Nations had declared no to plastics as a theme for this year. And they have highlighted the kind of damages which plastics do. For instance, microplastics are found in bodies of marine creatures, damaging them. They get into the food cycle and damage human health. Then they say that cattle and others eat them, and they also, in many cases, they even die because of ingestion of plastic and so on. So these are the issues. We do look forward to an illuminating presentation from Mr. P. Anbalagan so that all these issues can be clarified. So with these words, I welcome you once again. Thank you.
Yeah, it's on, it's on.
Good evening.
Is the voice all right?
All right?
Yes.
Good evening. Namaste. I'll have a brief, I'll take 2 minutes brief why the ban is at all by the state of Maharashtra. So typically, like almost 12 years back in 2006, Maharashtra had an act called Biodegradable Garbage Control Act, under which Biodegradable Garbage Control Act, under which we also issued a notification, which predominantly like controls manufacture of plastic bags less than 50 microns. Why? Because normally when the thickness goes down, the weight of the bag also goes down, and the recycler, they don't pick up because of the typically the less value. For example, if a kg of whatever like recycled plastic, 15 rupees, the plastic carry bags hardly weighs 3 to 4 grams. So you just divide by 100,000 grams to collect 1 kg. Almost 250 times the guy has to bend down to pick up. So entire this garbage, particularly the plastic carry bags, in, they end up in the dump. The same notification has a smaller class. After looking at the implementation and the response of these rules, if everything is like taken care of, recycling is done, then we can continue the same practice. If not, then the government can think of again further regulating or further putting restriction on such manufacture of such products. Then comes the plastic carry bag ban. I'll just quote a small example. We have like 262 urban local bodies across the state, and we generate roughly 24,000 metric tons of garbage, solid waste per day. Out of that, 1,200 metric tons is only a plastic, which is predominantly 60% to 80% is a carry bags, not the bottles, not the high value items. So calculate per month, roughly we produce around we like almost 40,000 metric tons. In a year, we generate 5 lakh metric tons. It's only a plastic carry bags and accessories. I am not leaving, I'm not considering the pets and other value, the plastic products which have a good market value. Since 1 year is like 5 lakh, and it's we cover only 50% of the population. 50% of the population lives in rural area. Just calculate for 10 years, it's a 50 lakhs, 5 million. So that is where these particularly plastic carry bags do not have a much recycling value. They are not being collected, and also better civic sense to prevail. So 12 years is a good period to do the experiment and also given a chance for the citizens and also the traders. So now it is the right time, as Sir was mentioning, it's an opportune time that we should like do a like stricter, like stringent reforms as far as this plastic carry bags is concerned. So then on, we had like almost 6 to 7 months, we had a lot of deliberations, went to all the divisional headquarters, like starting from Nagpur, Amravati, Aurangabad, Nasik, Mumbai. I had so many meetings with our minister, our additional chief secretary. They were all in like full flow. Then we have discussed with all the stakeholders, particular, and also all the implementers, all the local bodies, municipal councils, they were also being considered. Their inputs also taken into that. Then this notification was issued on 23rd. I'll have like, there are, this notification predominantly looks at three items on which there is a restriction. One is simply a plastic carry bags. With handle, without handle, any without any size restriction, without any thickness restriction, anything which is a plastic carry bags, even with like anything you get it from a beautiful bags from jewelry or beautiful bag from any shopping complex, supermarkets, they're all been covered under this. They're not been allowed now. This is one thing. Second is all the single-use disposable items, all this typically cutleries, plates, spoons, all the cutleries. We normally like whenever people go on picnic and even in small places, even in villages in Maharashtra, I don't think that it was a practice 10 years back. For all wedding and other things and even in temple celebration, these disposable cutleries are being used. They are dumped and they are unattended. Again, they also have a less value because their like weight also hardly like 6 to 7 gram, hardly it's more than 10 gram. Even a plate with a like thermocol weighs maybe less than 7 to 8 grams. This is second items, all the disposable items. Third is like thermocol. Thermocol, particularly thermocol used for a decoration and plastic used for a decoration. These are the three items on which there is a full restriction. And there are also exemptions. There are also exemptions. All the PET bottles, like packaged water, water includes like drinks, anything. Anything packaged in PET bottles, PET, like polytetraplate, also esters, PET, PET, the type of, all the containers, they are exempted, provided you have a printed buyback system and also the company which is producing should put up a mechanism wherein which they should be able to collect 10% and they should be able to channelize the 10% other recycling. That is called extended producer responsibility. I produce, I take responsibility to get it back. This is one thing. And typically exemptions are like all the milk pouches, it is untouched. All the packaging which is an integral part, like you ask, for example, anything like even a shampoo, oil, ghee, anything is an integral part of a manufacturing. That is also exempted. So there is no fear that like if I buy a shampoo packet, absolutely it is untouched as of now as per the current notification. And anything manufactured in an export oriented unit for export. So domestic trade, though the notification still puts ban on the domestic trade of the plastic carry bags. But anybody who is manufacturing for export, it is also and milk pouches also like again there is a particular period given for an experiment. Again, that also milk pouch also should have a buyback mechanism with a printed buyback price. So generally, all plastic carry bags, whether it is like a polyethylene or anything, and also non-woven fabrics, which we normally we in any temples, normally we used to be given to carry prasad. They looks like typically a cotton bags, white, nicely printed. They are all non-woven fabric, which doesn't require it's simple extrusion. Doesn't require any thread or a plastic thread stitching, it doesn't require. It's simple extrusion takes care of a cut and extrusion takes care of that. So though all non-woven fabrics are also banned in that. So there are only three things. Otherwise, packaging material, industrial packaging is allowed. And there were a lot of queries from like Mumbai Grah Panchayat, retailers, that what about it talks about only industrial packaging and packaging is an integral part of manufacturing. So government is about to give a clarification on the like packaging side. So the export committee recently has recommended that this packaging needs to be clarified and it should be like it should include both retailing at the retail level and also at the wholesale level. So I don't think that any packaging as far as now is concerned, it is banned under notification. Only thing is, any packaging material should have a code of a plastic. What is it like if you have a 7 to 8 type of plastic, what exactly the code and who is the manufacturer? These two details need to be there. Any packing material, even like masala, anything if you are packing, but if the packing material, the package, if if they don't have anything, then that is to be like seized and again it is liable for action. Otherwise, absolutely there are clarity, absolutely clarity on that. There is only a clarity required for a packaging. The government will be soon issuing that. Anything more, I think, anything more on that? During the interaction, I can respond. This is in nutshell what exactly the current notification is there. And 3 months are given for the whatever like to do a homework, to do our like keep our home in order. So that ends on like 23rd. So from 24th, as of now, the government is like free to initiate any action.
Thank you, Dr. Anbalagan.
How do you propose to deal with it?
Sir, like plastic can be recycled in like multiple ways, but the better way, which is environmentally free, is again converting back to plastic, not to oil. So converting back to, say, like we say, China is a plastic capital of the world, where every toy we get is made of a recycled plastic. 10 rupees we get a plastic. The entire waste goes to China. So we should have a like, sir, the rule also, 2016 rules, also provides for a separate mechanism by the urban local body so that they will collect the plastic and they will themselves, they should put up a facility to recycle it. Recycling is like, if you have a quality like PET, PET, even a quality HDB and all, you can go back to the again plastic beads. Again, you go back to plastic beads. Again, of course, they cannot be used for a food grade material. Once the recycled plastic cannot be used for a food grade, it can be used for a non-food grade activities like a mat, anything we can make in that. Second is like pyrolysis, like where we do a, like, it's like a typically a conversion into an oil in the absence of oxygen or a limited oxygen. So we get an oil like a typically furnace oil or a LDO, which has a typically as good as a diesel and has a good market. But our country, except barring 2-3 facilities, this furnace oil, again, it needs to be done at a closed loop. You're not supposed to leave any emissions, any smoke outside. Because again, plastic is not only plastic. Again, the plastic bottle will have a PVC covering. It has a three type. Even a bottle has a lid is a different plastic. The bottle is a different plastic. The label is a different thing. So the label cannot be recycled, except it has to be burned in the incinerator at around roughly 1000 plus degrees centigrade. So if you are burning together in an, like a typical, very unconventional method of like very not unsophisticated method of dealing, like even they simply they open burning, they do, they get oil like you can see oil like bitumen. It can give like a bitumen. It typically looks like a bitumen. Of course, its viscosity is less, so it flows. So that all gives like gives an emission, which again may lead to carcinomas, like basically cancers. So that way, typically, sir, it should be like non-burning, non-pyrolytic method, which we should recommend, and that should be on a high scale. And we should go for, otherwise, we should go for a co-processing, where like we will burn all the plastic in cement clean, which normally cement clean operates at a temperature of 900 to 1200. With all these dioxin, furans are taken care of. So it, all the material goes into ash. Again, that fly ash can be used for a like green. So plastic nowhere goes. Again, there are like ways wherein which there are recommendations to make road, particularly it can replace 7 to 10% of bitumen. So that also we are trying, and recently government has also issued a circular that almost all the government roads should have minimum 10% of, particularly 10% of the bitumen component should be from plastic. Only thing is soiled plastic, again it needs a washing, drying, shredding. So that way, sir, actually that's what, like, even if we segregate the plastic, it should be segregated in a way that can be used for a recycling. Otherwise, you put the same bottle also with the half of the juice, then again it needs a lot more to clean it, and we need more water to clean it before recycling.
Thank you, Dr. Anbalagan. I think people are also waiting to hear what and how Mumbai City is going to see the implementation and all the queries that come in from the citizens. As I said right in the beginning, that the larger bodies of the manufacturers and the the retailers, they do have a voice, but I think a lot of queries have come from the common citizen, because there is a lot of confusion. They're not able to understand the differences, etc. So we invite you, Ms. Choudhary, to clarify some of the things in your opening remarks.
Sure.
And what else you would want from the citizens, because I think as responsible citizens, we need to know and discharge a civic duty. That is there. But clarity is required to understand the ban.
I would like to begin from where sir has left, the role of municipal corporations, the urban local bodies. So if we go through the notification of 23rd March 2018, the notification has primarily given two responsibilities. One was of collection mechanism. So on that part, Municipal Corporation of Greater Mumbai has set up collection centers at 37 driveway segregation centers. All the municipal markets, there are 97 retail markets of Municipal Corporation across the city of Mumbai. There also the system has been set up. In addition to it, we provided a toll-free number to all the citizens of Mumbai where if they are not in a position to come to the collection center, they can just make a call to 1-800-222-357, which was the toll-free number that we have provided to citizens for past 3 months. And there are 24 vans which have been provided for this very task. So we have been running these vans across the wards of Municipal Corporation and collecting the plastic, banned plastic. And in this regard, I'm happy to share with all of you that people so far, till yesterday, the data tells that over 1,42,000 kgs of plastic has been collected through societies, houses. People have called us up and that is the extent of plastic which we have collected. In addition to it, what sir has rightly mentioned in his remark is extended producer responsibility. So Municipal Corporation of Greater Mumbai has got Coca-Cola and Bisleri and the Plastic Manufacturers Association, who have also been collecting the banned plastic through their different mechanism. They have also been collecting through societies and their number is around 2 lakh kgs of plastic. So that much plastic we have been able to collect, which was the responsibility given to the corporation. The second part was implementation. So how are we going to implement? But before that comes a part which was of making people aware about the subject. What is banned, what is not banned, how are we going to do it? So we have been trying for past 3 months to bring awareness about the subject. We initially went with the self-help group trainings because plastic alternative is to be provided. So Municipal Corporation of Greater Mumbai has around 100 plus a self-help group which are working on alternatives. So we provided them trainings and we actually ensured that they move towards making cloth bags, jute bags, paper bags. So that is what was done. All the municipal markets were first targeted and they were linked with the self-help groups. In addition to it, 1st May being the Maharashtra Day, that day we ran, basically there were vehicles which were which displayed the messages of plastic ban and what are the alternatives available with self-help group women on those vans which were providing the alternatives to the citizens, which ran across the city of Mumbai. In addition to it, there were street plays which were organized on bus stops, railway stations to make people aware about it. Besides the social media campaign that the MCGM Twitter handle of Swachh Bharat Abhiyan is already doing on the subject. We had roped in some celebrities on the subject. To bring more clarity about the subject, we are organizing an exhibition on plastic alternatives from 22nd to 24th in Worli, which is all kinds of alternatives. What sir has said, the plastic carry bags of with or without handle are under ban, has said that thermocol cutlery is under ban, then what is the alternative available to citizens? Straw are under ban, then what is the alternative for a nariyal wala? So we want to know the alternatives. For that the exhibition is there. So there are over 60 companies which are manufacturing the plastic alternative products and around 50 self-help groups which are going to display their products from 22nd to 24th, that is from tomorrow, for 3 days. So that is what we tried to do on awareness part. Besides engaging media, social, print media, TV media. Now coming to the implementation part, which people are more keen to know how much is the staff, how much is the workforce that we have deployed for this task. We have 249 dedicated team. It's basically inspectors of three departments have been pulled in. First is the shop and establishment department, which is going to check the shops, malls. If there is a banned plastic, then they are going to take action. Second is the market department. So they are basically going to focus on municipal markets and also the private markets and malls. Then third is the license department. So they are going to focus on the hawkers, street vendors, stalls which are there on footpath and in the streets. So this team of around 249 inspectors has been roped in. We have given them training three times. And what fear is there in the people of in the minds of people of Mumbai? We are also aware of it, and we have trained them that the implementation essentially is on single-use plastic, as sir has said, that it is on the plastic carry bags of any micron size, on the cutlery and thermocol decorative items. So these three specific themes is what we are going to carry on with, and we have given them authority letter, we have given them an identity card, we have given them a waistcoat which will identify them from other inspectors. We have uploaded their details on our website so that if people have any query, if they really want to check whether the person has been authorized by BMC to collect the fine, so please go to our website, web portal, all the details of these three inspectors have been given there. So this is what we have done so far, and as sir has mentioned, the Maharashtra Non-Biodegradable Garbage Control Act, the authority to collect fine, the authority to implement this notification comes from that act. Under that act, section 9 tells for first offense it will be up to 5,000, for second offense it is up to 10,000, and subsequent offense it is 25,000 rupees and 3 months jail. So I know that's probably the reason for worry for each one of us, that the fine is 5,000, 10,000, and then 25,000 and 3 months jail. So I only have an appeal and request from this platform that we are all on one side only, making the city better ecologically and environmentally also. And this ban, if implemented properly in letter and spirit, and if citizens support, I'm sure the floodings that we see in Mumbai, the drainage blockages that we see in Mumbai during monsoons, with this year's implementation, certainly it is going to help each one of us in the coming year. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Choudhary. Actually, from what you have mentioned, there are still many questions, because as I said, that bulk generators are one side, but when we look at the common person, each one of us, we are confused and need clarity that when you say about the packaging, when I say you, I don't mean I both my sides, right and left, that it looks identical, but the vegetables, you know, like the food thing is banned, whereas the other may not. So like that, like certain other items which are actually banned as per the notification and something is not. So we have an appeal and a request that there are few items, because from the questions that we have been receiving for the last, ever since we said that we are having the social sanchar, that what is this and which is this banned or not? I'll start first from the segregation point, because as Dr. Anbalagan has just mentioned, that without segregation, nothing begins, which is our pet subject. That's how we all, many of us, got involved in all this work. If you're looking at segregation, the first thing are the garbage bags that the waste is collected in the households. Now, forever since we started, it was always a black and a white. Subsequently, I think the color has changed. Now, the question comes in with compostable bags, right, if I'm not mistaken. Now, who are the vendors and whether everything is properly identified? I have, I think, Mr. Billimore here, who has got a compostable bag. If I may request him to give us a sample, he should be somewhere around. But what we have done is, we have collected a few items that were brought to our notice, And we thought that we would ask you, appeal to both of you, to identify if, for example, this particular item is banned or not, because these are the sort of questions we have received. And the understanding of the ban, for that purpose, it is being shared. So may I request to just see. Now, if we see these two packaging, one is of, it's the same, product is the same, as in it's to do with coconut. One is edible and the other is non-edible. Now, the material, I am told, from the expert committee, I mean, the people who do the manufacturing, is the same. So now, which one is banned and which is not?
Both are not under ban.
Both are not banned.
No.
How very nice. So that means, if this is one, now, are there any, the common things that we have seen of chips, for example, oh, this is also there.
Also not banned.
This is also not banned. That's good news, or bad news, I don't know. But one thing is certain, which Dr. Anbalagan has said, that we need to recycle our waste. Now, if you see this, now most of the many shops will be, some are packaged and some comes in the transparent bags when you take it up. Will you just put it up a little? So for example, and this is a very common thing, and I'm sure the school children sitting here are anxiously waiting to know which one they can use and which they can't. So
Can I respond?
Yes, please.
See. That comes like nearby looking at the left one, you feel that it is a primary packaging.
Yes.
It is done at the time of manufacturing.
Right.
Like, apparently.
Right.
This normally one, particularly urban local bodies, will think that I'll buy it in bulk and I'll do it as a secondary.
Correct.
But most probably both of them may be primary.
Quite possible.
Quite possible. So
yes.
On that we are issuing rejoinder, like a clarification. Give me the bag, that one.
Yes.
Only thing is, you cannot sell like this. The manufacturer name need to be on this, and you'll have a plastic code where from you have purchased. Suppose this is not sold like a bag, it's not sold like a tube or a like sheet. They are like cut pieces, they are sold,
right.
Only we will do this. So the cut pieces would have like a number, the manufacturer's code and the plastic type, whether A, B, C, whether it is, that's it. Only thing is, what is the time limit to be given to come back to this? That like our expert committee headed by the minister will decide. As of now, I think we don't take any coercive action on these two. So very specifically, I like speak with responsibility. Government will come up with a clarification. Only thing is, you cannot sell like this. A manufacturer name needs to be printed, how so far, like how remote he is manufacturing. And then you need to have at least two details. Where from the plastic has come, like from whom you have purchased, and the plastic code. What is the type of plastic?
So having said this, then what about the Ziploc bags? I'm saying because these questions have come.
They're all banned. Ziploc bags are banned.
Ziploc bags are all banned.
That is not a packaging. It's a
right.
Packaging.
This is a packaging. So that means in the household, because we will come to that. We have a few items. Then we will come to the question. So don't worry, we are not stopping it. All I'm saying is that in the households, there is a common practice of having Ziploc bags to put the vegetable, cut vegetables, etc. So those...
These are not banned.
These are not banned.
No, they are not banned.
Okay. No. So...
Milk.
So...
Milk, oil, anything, it is not banned. It is packaged. Only thing is, they have to... print the manufacturers and plastic details and the buyback cost, price of the pouch. Suppose even the pouch is like unattended at the ground, somebody collects. It's not that you will go and give it for a 50 paise. So basic purpose of like this buyback system is someone at least will collect it as a value and give it to the either the vendor or retailer, whosoever is authorized.
Right. So then in that case, may I add to a little, if I'm correct in understanding, that from the household where such a bag would have been purchased and be used, once the use is over, and should any householder want to use that packaging, which is allowed, as you said, clean it and use it, will there be an issue or is there a time limit? Because when the person is out on the street, if I ask how it will be, because again, this is a question asked.
You mean to say
can we use it?
You cut the milk pouch and you use the milk and you also clean the milk pouch.
Yes.
You can use it.
You can use it. So in that case, the question will come up is that, because this was again from the students, if I may say, that when they are going out and the mobile or etc., they want to put it inside because in the rainy season it might get spoiled.
It is a reuse.
It's a reuse.
Only thing is they should not litter it.
Ah, that of course is another issue. So let us look at this, for example. These sachets are allowed?
They're all allowed?
They're all allowed. Right. So
I don't know, only there are three items. You are confusing so much.
Yeah. Ah, but that is exactly what has happened, across. And I have been bombarded with questions coming in. And there is...
All this is allowed.
Yeah. Even this with plastic wrapper... from the manufacturing is allowed, without plastic wrapper is allowed, with a multi-layer is also allowed. We are regulating these packaged material by EPR and other things. For a citizen, you have to collect it separately and hand it over to the municipality separately. That's it.
Oh, perfect. Which then leads me to one question, Mr. Choudhary, if you would like to clarify, that the dry van collection for dry waste will still be applicable, right?
Yes. Excellent. It is going to continue because, like sir has already said, that there are lots of products on which EPR mechanism is going to work. So these EPR products, basically, all citizens are expected to keep in a separate bin in their house.
Right.
So all these wrappers, which right now have been shown, please put it in a separate bin and then give it to the municipal corporation. Otherwise, also we know at house segregation of dry, wet, plastic, metal should be done. So if that way it is done and given to municipal corporation, our team and vans will continue working.
Well then, this is an excellent news for the whole campaign of segregation of waste, because willy-nilly we have to make sure that we segregate correctly. So that's the bottom line. Are there any more packets? All these are allowed. So irrespective of the product inside, these packaging, it is allowed. Now, this is...
What is that material inside?
It's paper plates.
Paper plates in a plastic wrapper. So the point comes in of the... It follows the same plastic?
Same rules. It has to be more than like 50 microns. You cannot have a thinner plastic for this covering. 50 microns plus. Then that plastic also should have a label.
Label. Right.
Who is the manufacturer? What is the type of plastic? Otherwise, it is like illegal.
Right. Now, that means is... just a minute. We'll come to the questions. Just hold your thoughts. We'll come to the questions. That means in the household level, cling film, which is used quite commonly, cling film. So is that very thin plastic which is covered for freshness of fruit, food, and etc. Is that also banned?
See, as a plastic film, we don't use anywhere. Though the notification covers, but we would like request citizens not to use that. Since you do the plastic sheet, if you cut, you will not have a seat. The seat comes in a roll, like a spindle or a cloth, it comes in a roll. Seat also comes in a roll. The roll at the end will have a thing, maybe at a certain distance, certain length, it will have its characteristics. And if you have a plastic without any remark, then it is like a band. So better not to use it.
Well, then in that case, perhaps the, because it comes in a packaging, unfortunately, I don't think we are carrying one of the samples.
This is what we were talking about. I'll just clarify. If you are using it, what is it?
Inside.
Open it.
Every household uses it.
Can we open it?
Just see that.
No, this is a plastic wrapper. That's
allowed. That's manufacturing.
That's manufacturing. But the point comes in is what is inside. Because this is commonly used and that's the reason. This is very commonly used, and I'm fairly certain.
Normally, plastic seats, this you are not supposed to use.
No, 1 minute. We don't make our own statements. We are here with the regulator and implementer.
There are single disposable items. This is a single disposable.
No, not necessarily. This is used a couple of times. I don't know whether this is.
But these things we don't like.
It's put on fruits, vegetables.
It has to be, ma'am, it's not a 50 micron. It's not a 50.
This
it's not allowed. It comes in thin thing. You cannot have a 50 micron plus for a fruits and other thing. It will not allow any oxygen inside. So better not to use it. It will not be allowed.
Okay. So then we are very clear about this because I don't know how many questions I have received for this. So therefore, it's very clear This is certainly not allowed. So please use the foil. All right.
This is considered as a single-use disposable item, so it's not allowed. Simple.
One minute. I have to please say that any question, any statement you want to make, please do so with a mic, because this is a live program and nothing will go otherwise. Are there any other items that we wanted clarity on? These are all not banned. So which means basically the reason why we got this is because the cap is made of plastic, but all this you are saying is exempt. Is that right? Please don't speak without a mic. So I'm going to request, we'll come to the questions now, but bottom line is I'm going to request on this platform that please item wise clarify what is banned and what is not, because by reading the notification, it's not possible for the common man to understand the items. As you just saw.
I would say yes. Plastic carry bag.
Yes.
Plastic carry bag.
Let's hear very clearly.
Plastic carry bag, irrespective of size.
Correct.
Thickness.
Yes.
How good it is. It is banned.
It's banned. Okay.
All single-use plastic and thermocol items. This all comes in single use, not necessarily cutleries, all single use plastic and thermocol items, they are all banned. And third is cutlery, it's already there. Third is like all the items, same items for a decoration. You have a flower bouquet, the same thing. You cannot cover it with plastic. Simple. Bouquet, you have flowers, you cannot have wrap it with a.
Yes,
they're
the cellophane.
They are all not allowed.
Ma'am, please, I'm appealing to all of you. If you speak without the mic, then it doesn't get recorded. We'll come to questions. At that point, please ask. There is another clarification we need. Now, for example, this is a sample, and I say this because it's come to my society. The manufacturer of this, they say that this is compostable waste collection bag. Now, with a string. Now, there is no marking. And it's being sold in
allowed.
Trust. So now the point comes, one minute. The point comes in, just one moment. There is, it's a very clear indication that today many manufacturers will come up with bags, or are coming, as you see now over here, which they are saying is compostable. Now it is not possible for the householders to actually know that whether it is compostable or not. So the appeal would be to the regulator that kindly identify or give a panel, because if it is not nothing is mentioned, and I should show you on WhatsApp that it's being marketed under the Tatas, under Trent. I don't know whether it is a hoax or what, but it is being given to societies. Now today people are not going to understand it, so some sort of mechanism, and I think.
Respond.
Yes, please.
Compostable packaging material. Though the notification says it's a compostable plastic, it is not a plastic. It is neither a polyethylene.
It's cornstarch. Correct.
Not necessarily corn. It's not like a PETE, like esters, or maybe polypropylene or a polystyrene. Not audible.
Yeah.
Now it's okay.
Now it's all right. Right.
Basically, they are like anhydrous biopolymers. They are anhydrous biopolymers, but typically you can say starch. There are like n number of like plant material. Typically they say it's a polylactic acid. They are like typically a biopolymers. And again, the notification is a provision. Whosoever is willing to sell, and now as of now, it is only allowed for nurseries, and secondly for the garbage. Because even if it is not segregated, it goes at least 6 to 7 months. It is like it will degrade. Now the certifying authority is only CPET. CPCB has to register give the registration, and CPCB, like Central Pollution Control Board, has given a mandate to CPET Chennai, the Plastic Institute CPET Chennai. The entire test takes 6 to 7 months. It's not a simple thing. The entire test takes, since biodegradable means it doesn't happen like our sewage or like a tomato or a cashew, like within 42 days. It takes 6 to 7 months, because it is also typically is like water resistant. It is also subjected to a lot of like chemical reactions. They have been made into more good like polymers. It's like a complex plant polymers. They are all like very stringent. You can use water, everything. So that way, the procedure is eliminated. Is the people should have a registration number from the CPCB, and again there is a standard from Indian standards also. This also has a standard. What we can do from for all the corporation, MCGM and of course MPCB can jointly identify those trusted thing. There are field tests. At least it's like we cannot go legally. We can tell them there are field tests which also can be identified. So like I can share like if it's a anybody is from chemistry background will understand dichloromethane. If you cut a piece of a like biopolymer and put it and shake it, it should dissolve within 10 to 15 seconds. So it's normal field test, it's a platform test practice in the entire European country. Otherwise, second test for particularly that our laboratory also we are going to like strengthen it. It's a simple like they say Fourier transform like infrared radiation. So with the spectral thing, whether we can identify, whether it's simple to identify plastic. If it is not a plastic, then it is a negative. We can go for it, can be a biopolymer. So that I think we can do maybe a listing and that can be hosted in website. Again, that we have to do with after the due diligence. Otherwise, like anybody with see, a curious thing can come up with a right. notion that it is a bio.
Yeah, that's exactly package. What I was saying, Dr. Anbalagan.
That
this
I think that,
what
that we can
shown.
Take initiative.
Yes.
MCGM also will do. We will identify them. We can
okay.
give a, like a, we can also advertise in paper and we can come up. We'll do a certification sort of thing to begin with. Then we can go ahead.
So the basic thing is that as an organization, we would like to assist to disseminate information and share with the public. Because this is going to happen a great deal. Because today we are, I don't know, as many people are watching, will probably be a little bit more aware of the waste collection bags. But this, if this is happening in South Mumbai, in Malabar Hill areas and other areas, quite rampant, and apparently it is available in Star Bazaar, I think, wherever it is. So perhaps a little bit of information on this, if we can assist to share
that
with the
can
public.
Be done. I think that
yes,
we will
work jointly on this to take it forward. Any other items that we have? No. Now the question answer session begins from your side. I just raised some of the things that had been collected as an issue in a large way. The online audience who are not present over here may be given a few questions we will take, and in between we will take audience questions. Please understand that we'll have to have a balance. Could we have questions on SMS? Ziploc bags, I think, has already been...
They are not allowed.
Not allowed. Okay. So that's clear.
Bags with handles, duty-free shops.
1 minute. There was a second question there.
Duty-free bags.
So the question came up, the question which came up otherwise also is that when people go out of Mumbai or out of India and they come back with duty-free bags into the international airport of Mumbai, what happens to those bags?
That I think we will direct airport authority to collect the bags and hand it over to ELP. It will not be allowed. That's
it cannot be allowed.
You can carry up to airport. You can carry up to airport.
Okay.
Can we
then in that case, the question comes up is, to be very, I would request, please ma'am and sirs, if you speak without a mic, it is not proper because we have an online audience. The point will come in with these bags is that when people travel and they bring and they buy something duty free, how will they carry it out of the airport? So if there is a mechanism that is going to be put in place, it would be...
Ma'am,
proper to let it be known.
I would respond like the rule is made for like a general presumption that things are working. See, you cannot make rules for each and every exceptions and exceptional cases. So only thing is we can direct airport authority. You can carry up to that. From there you have to make other arrangements. Maybe not inside. Maybe outside the airport you can like whosoever come to receive you can take that. That can be done. That is the only thing. Otherwise also you are carrying in the bag. You are not putting
so
it in the cabin baggage.
So in which case perhaps adding to that. You might want to say that they should have a collection back center or something outside.
Of course, 100%.
Because otherwise, 100%. It will be impossible. And whichever way you would like to, but some time will be required, I think, for the airport authorities to deal with this issue. So we leave it at that. Let's go back to the questions. We would like to take this, perhaps, Ms. Choudhary can answer.
MPCB also has an app prepared for plastic ban, particularly plastic carry ban. So go to MPCB website, and also there is an we'll give the details in MPCB website, Maharashtra Pollution Control website, and you can also download it in your Android. And I think most probably now it is also for iOS. We'll check it up. Otherwise, it also will be used for iOS, where your each and every queries are answered, as in the form of app.
We will flash it because we will announce it when we have it subsequently. So we will also use our portal, and because our social media, we will assist you in whichever way that we need to inform the public. Let us take an audience question, please. The mic. Yes, please.
First of all, please announce the website of MP's Pollution Control Board. Second question is of the municipal department which handles these bags and all that. They should have a website and they should announce that. Plus, you should have a frequently asked questions, queries, standard queries.
Right.
This should be replied in Hindi also, because all these English talk will not go to the people, the householders, and it should be in two languages.
It will be replied in Marathi and English.
Marathi
and time
English.
Available in Hindi also it will be.
No, Bombay is a cosmopolitan city.
Thank you.
We need at least one more language in addition to Marathi.
Right, right.
This is a request.
Yes,
frequently asked questions and email
type. May the answer be given, please?
Yeah. Aapke liye Mumbai Municipal Corporation ki website portal.mcgm.gov.in is ye website hai. But isme portal.mcgm Municipal Corporation for Greater Mumbai ka short form .gov.in. Is website par Municipal Corporation ke sabhi departments ki information hai. We are not having a separate dedicated website for plastic ban, lekin isme hamare implementation se related jitni events hain, jitni cheeze hain, wo sari is pe upload kar di gayi. Aap janna chahte hain ki kaun inspectors authorized kiye gaye, unke naam kya hain, wo sari detail hai. आपको alternatives जानने हैं कि jute bag manufacturers कौन हैं, cloth bag manufacturers कौन हैं, तो उनका भी एक information उस पे दे दिया गया है. Besides MCGM का Twitter handle, जो स्वच्छ भारत अभियान का Twitter handle है, उस पे इस तरह के question answer format में भी, in fact मैंने भी काफी question answer format में बना के अपनी clarity और public की clarity के लिए डाले हैं, वैसे उस Twitter handle पे भी डाले जा रहे हैं. So उसका at MCGM SWM, that's the Twitter handle for SWM department. So
aap
us pe dal sakte hain.
Excuse me.
Yes.
There are a lot of people who are having.
Keep the mic.
Which they are keeping in their home for so many times. Because whatever.
Will you not move your mic, please? Keep the mic in front of your face.
I'll do that.
Yes, thank you.
Because each citizens are having a lot of plastics in their home also. Because every day when we go out, we buy something and we collect it. And if the bags are put, we keep it in the house to reuse it. Now, if that cannot be used, where do we have to throw? Or who do we have to ask? Or who do we have to give? That is very important for us to understand.
I already told you that there are collection centers which have been set up at 37 areas in municipal corporation area jurisdiction. Besides, हमने टोल फ्री नंबर रिलीज किया था 1800222357. प्लीज आप अपने घर में कलेक्ट कीजिए सारा प्लास्टिक. 10 किलो से ज्यादा प्लास्टिक जैसे ही होता है फोन कीजिए, हमारी गाड़ी हम भेजेंगे ले जाएंगे.
द माइक में प्लीज बी सेंड दैट साइड
1800222357. आप अपने घर में सोसाइटी में प्लास्टिक कलेक्ट कीजिए, वी विल कलेक्ट इट.
द पॉइंट हियर इज देयर वर टू थिंग्स दैट वर सेड अबाउट हाउसहोल्ड collection of multiple use plastic. The centers are there. We have also put it out and we will keep on repeating, supporting the MCGM and MPCB as the information comes. But most important of all, please separate your waste at source, at a household level, and the dry waste van will come and pick up your dry waste appropriately from there. Am I right? Now when you pick up the dry waste, it is not just plastic, there are other items like tins, etc. will also go in there. There's another question coming in. Just wait, ma'am, till we take a SMS question.
As of now, there is no ban on flex banners.
Thank you, we are saved. Our banner at the back is flex.
But we will appreciate agar ye bhi kapde mein banaya ja sake.
Yes.
Next event.
That is why, right in the beginning, I said I absolutely appreciate very unique stat. Just a minute. Sirs, what? Come on. If you keep talking in between, then we will not hear. And your voice will not be heard by anybody except the few who are here. I was just commenting on the fact that this unique standee of Mahindra's gives us a great idea, particularly for the students, to take up a profession in banner making. Banner making of different, it's a very unique banner. It's not just put, you know, just a few images put, but it's done in a different way. Just a thought. There was a question to your right. Yes.
Yeah.
Who has the mic, please?
I have the mic here.
Yes, please.
I have a question for Doctor. Sir, I'm from the food industry. And you said non-woven material is not allowed, plastic. These caps are used very extensively, not only in the food industry, in food processing, in hospitals and everywhere. They are one-time caps, but will they be allowed or not permitted?
Medical, technical textiles or medical fabrics are allowed.
Sorry?
Actually, non-woven fabric carry bags.
But these kind of caps would
that
be
is
permitted?
They are technical textiles, they are allowed.
They are now. They are,
it's only a carry bag. As far as non-woven is concerned, it's only a carry bag. Otherwise, non-woven has a lot of, like, even blood transfusion bags.
So I think we will do one thing for sure. We have a date with both my right and left hand to make sure that we make pictorials and make sure that we publicize. Is that okay with you? Because some of these questions will come up, so we'll spend some time to understand. Where's the mic, please?
Yeah.
Madam, yes, please.
Madam, one question only. Is non-woven bag is allowed?
If you don't have the mic, it makes no difference. Just wait.
No, I make around ke ye jo non-woven bag dete hain. So jo de rahe hain ye log to wahan pe
bhi. This is what? This is plastic?
Notification say it's a plastic.
Non-woven plastic.
Ye allowed nahi hai.
It's not allowed.
Allowed nahi hai. Bag allowed nahi hai.
Sir, good evening.
Yes, please.
Hello.
There are many hands going up.
Hello.
Please, excuse Hello? Me, request silence, please.
Hello.
Yes, please.
Sir, just a simple question. In Mumbai, there are 1.3 crore people. And plastic bag manufacturers, cutlery manufacturers will not be more than 500. Why don't we stop them, or you personally tell them to stop manufacturing so that we don't all get arrested? And second, so no, please, 1 second. 5,000 rupees, 10,000 rupees, 25,000 rupees, fine. Does it not seed the thought for corruption to manage the whole problem?
I'll respond for your first query. We have like 500 odd manufacturers, particularly plastic carry bags. And cutleries, registered manufacturers, we are inventorizing it. And for a plastic carry bags, we have not renewed them. And they're like as good as they're all closed. There will be complete ban on like manufacture. That the government will ensure. Only thing is, typically carry bags and these cutleries, I would say hardly we manufacture 30% in our state. The plastic capital is Daman and DU. So we don't get, we don't manufacture more than 30% in our state. So 70% comes from outside. So we are doing for both the same. See, we have to live without plastic also. See, you have to see convenience, comfort, and also the environment.
Correct.
There were the days like we were like living without any plastic. Now also you are having 90% of the plastic. Plastic carry bags, even in entire volume of business also, hardly may not be more than 10%. And even including these disposables, they are not more than 10 to 15%. So manufacturing also that we are not renewed, and we will impose a stricter ban on those things. Only thing is, we are also receiving material from other states. Like we are surrounded by all the states. So that also, there comes the citizens' participation.
Right. Just a minute. No. We are not going to take a second one. Just a minute. I would like the students who are here, because they are the future generation, so we would like to take a question from them.
You should like respond for us.
Good evening, everyone.
Just a minute, please. This is a SMS question we are taking, which has come from your school. You're from Pawar Public?
Yeah, Pawar Public.
Yes? Okay. One of the question here, then once this is answered, then you ask a question.
Sure.
Just stay put, stand there. Yes, please.
Basically, a receipt is given to a person, and we will be keeping a copy of the receipt in times of counterclaims, etc. So if the person is not having the money, essentially he can actually request that where is the nearest CFC center of municipal corporation, there he can make payment through other modes also. However, it's a good suggestion that has come. We should provide the some electronic payment
electronic
system
payment.
Also
yes.
to
That's
the citizens.
Yes.
So we maybe we can think of working on that subject
like,
also. However,
like
we
the traffic
e-challans
that has been, become
can
quite
I?
Successful. I would like to let the student answer
Good
question.
Evening. Yeah, I'm having a question for you. How will the government employ 3 lakh people who have lost their jobs because of plastic ban?
Perfect.
I'll respond.
Yeah?
I'll respond.
Yeah, sure.
Plastic carry bag. It's not a plastic bag. Your mobile mobile also has a plastic. Your mic which you are holding is also having a plastic.
Yes.
Your shirt also has a plastic. Buttons. It's a simply a 5 to 7%, not even more than that. And this is going to, in case if you, the numbers 3 lakhs are all unfound. No statistics say 3 lakhs. Even in Maharashtra, we have only 442 units. Only 10 or 5. It's only 8 by 8 is required. 8x8 is required to do the this, both the like single use cutleries and also that doesn't make much like 10x10 rooms and only maybe like 10,000, but this alternate like compostable, the cloth bags and also even paper bag, though we don't like advocate, like Sava's mentioning again and again, environmental cost will be there. I would say it will have like it will multiples of at least 5 multiples of employment will be generated on that. More employment will be generated on this restriction.
Thank
you. Will
you.
Not lose any employment.
So could
Thank
we
you.
Say then that plastic restrictions be used a lot more than ban, because that is the ban word is what is creating the banning. I'm just saying.
We never said plastic ban. It's a plastic carry bag.
It's
the single
so
use plastic.
Yeah, it's the single use plastic on which the
plastic
ban is
carry
there.
Carry bag, single use items and thermocol.
Thermocol
even the package, it is not banned. Thermocol is outside.
So then do we change the hashtag to plastic restrictions instead of ban? Or regulate. I think restrictions is more, because when you have something restricted, if you all agree, we start using that hashtag, because it will make more sense, because so many people are saying how is it banned. So the term ban is creating far more panic than is actually
required. It's basically a regulation, and as I initially mentioned, there are 3 items on which the complete restriction, the ban is there.
Right.
So you have to qualify your whatever hashtag. Ban need to apply, but whether it's a plastic or a plastic carry bag, ban need to be there.
So ban is there. Ban.
Otherwise, restriction will
restriction.
Not like.
So ban is to make sure that there is a big stick somewhere.
Can
so
I?
Good, in a way. Yes, please.
Both for the regulator and the BMC. Let me tell you, India is the only country.
No, the question.
No, I'm giving question.
Yes.
Where 100% plastic is collected and organized in every organized way. Early morning, they rat pickers, they pick up. I have a question. In a society, the fellow picks up the entire thing and he gives it to the, he separates out the plastic, gives it to Kabadiwala. So while taking it to Kabadiwala, will he be caught? Or if I give it to Kabadiwala, I collect sizable plastic and give it to a recycler, unorganized recycler. Am I be caught in that?
You will not be caught. Only thing is get yourself registered with a close to your like BMC office.
No, because you see there is no ban. There is only one bin.
Just a minute, sir. No, are you asking?
I am asking question.
I'll classify your like statement. The notification also says there are citizen groups, citizen, individual citizen or a citizen groups can help in imposing this restriction. That can be also in the way of this. Only thing is that we have appointed some 28 odd like competent authorities. So you have to enroll with that one of the guy, local. You have to register with him that I am going to do. If anybody goes that it carries, that I will be carrying, then I say I am going to dispose of that. There is no restriction. You only said it is, we have 1.3 crore people here. So you have to register with the local authorized signate.
Right, I think the... There is, just a minute ma'am, please. There is a gentleman with the hand up, if the mic can be given. For a long time I've been seeing, and even that side. So, yes please.
As a grocery stores, generally we have 3 types of bags in our shop. One is the carry bag, which has been banned. The second bag is the carry bag which
please
you showed.
Please do not speak between.
The second one is the pouch pack which you showed of the banana chips in a transparent pack. The third one which we use, like a loose grocery with the rice, dals, which come directly from the APMC market. We pack them in this bags and we tie a knot in this, which can be opened and reused. Now, what has to be done with these bags?
Carry bags are disallowed.
Yes.
Secondly, don't say they are bags. They are like packaging material.
We call it as PP in a...
So, these zipped bags are not packaging, but they are not integral.
No, they are not zip bags. They are just a simple bags.
Any bag you cannot do as... I told you, if you want to package it, you label it.
Okay.
Use only 50 micron plus.
Right.
And the bag also should have where from the plastic has come.
Right.
What is the plastic code?
Right.
If it is there and if you are having your manufacturing thing and you are sealing it, not a zip bag.
Yeah.
It is allowed. Again, for that,
yeah,
the government is yet to issue a clarification, but it will be issued.
No,
that's
third thing, when the product are loosed, say for a rice in a guni bag, they need, how the customer needs to carry that to the house?
Dr. Anbalagan, you have already made it very clear, once and for all, for this particular question, let's make it clear that if there are anything which is not already in a package state, the sheet, wherever you buy it from, that should have the two labels which has already been answered. Let's go to some other question. The gentleman at the back, please. Yes, in the purple shirt, because you've been raising your question. And then we'll come back to you, ma'am. Do you have the mic?
Respected ma'am, there's a big confusion with respect to use of plastic containers by hotel and restaurant people. Are these allowed for parcel and takeaway orders?
As of now, it is not allowed.
Not allowed.
So,
what are the alternatives available?
It's not allowed. You have to have an aluminium container.
Just a minute, please. Without the mic, please don't speak. How much am I going to appeal? If we can't be disciplined here, how are we going to be disciplined outside? Just wait, take the mic and... will you please
liquid items like dal and gravy items will not hold in aluminium containers.
See, we are not here to discuss the philosophical item and also the industry perspective. It's all been done after the lot of deliberation. As of now, it is banned. What is an alternative that you come to office will discuss the alternative. This is not a forum to discuss.
Let's hear the alternative.
Rather than coming to that, yes.
Let's hear the alternative.
Please visit the tomorrow's exhibition. There are all alternatives available to these options. One minute. Let me make one thing clear. I understand that many of you are from the industry. I know that many of you are from the industry. I would appeal to you that you have another way of approaching the authorities to take it up in a more systematic manner. This is more for the common citizens, and let us restrict ourselves to the items that affect our households first. And that will be highly appreciated, because otherwise we will have an issue. Yes, please.
This is probably the second time I'm asking this question in a forum.
Please have the mic up in front.
Right.
Please talk loudly. Is the mic not on? I would request. It is on? Okay.
So this is the second time I'm asking the same question in this forum. Excuse me, can you please move? Thank you. The question is for people who are invalid, sick, patients at home or in a hospital. You use things like diapers, you use things like draw sheets, which all contain plastic. If you ban those, give me an alternative.
Those are not banned.
You haven't mentioned that. You said all plastic is banned. Anything banned below 50 microns.
It's carry bag.
Carry bags are
carry bag.
My second question. You made a statement to say that as soon as you come out of the airport, dispose of your plastic bags. Right? Those plastic bags come sealed when you travel from wherever you're traveling from. Who's going to provide you bags to carry all your duty-free items? Answer. And
Make it loud. What exactly the response you want?
Sorry?
Make it loud. I'm not clear.
Give us
about duty-free products.
What exactly you want?
I said, what alternative do you have? You want us to rip the plastic bag, deposit it at the airport. That was your response.
I'll just say, it is only a carry bag.
It is a carry bag. Right? So, which is sealed. When you come out of a duty-free,
carry bags are not
it's
sealed.
How can you open
yes,
it?
Yes, in the
can you provide to open it?
Duty free, they will. See.
Can you provide to open it?
You will see. Duty free, you will after.
It's not loose. It's sealed. It's not loose.
Let me finish my response. Duty free, you will finish after you check in. After your security checkup, check in. Duty free is not before that. In some of the countries, a few times. If you are putting it in the cabin bag, baggage, then of course, then
yes,
it will come with you.
No, the point
but
I
see
I,
to begin with, we will also issue a clarification.
You know, this is like catching a bull by its tail.
Just a minute,
issue is like our appeal is like we should find out a solution,
right.
And we find out 100 reasons how not to do. And no one is here is suggesting how we cannot do it.
Right.
If so, that is the, like, if we are...
Yes,
like,
sir. Can I ask you one question which is not related to any of this?
We will issue a clarification on that.
Yes.
Can I ask you a question which is not related to this?
No, 1 minute. If that is related to what you have already asked, then let me also suggest then, perhaps the airport, the duty-free shops or wherever could use an alternative so that there is no issue or provide... I mean, it's just offhand, but we may discuss that and find an alternative, because the idea is also to find solutions to issues that may be plaguing so that ultimately we all benefit.
We can issue a clarification.
Yes.
That is only in Bombay. What happens when you come in from wherever in the world?
That's right. So on that, let there be clarity.
Point is well taken.
Yes, point is well taken.
Well taken.
Let us see one more questions over here. This is one of the Twitter questions, I think. Yes.
Plastic gloves are allowed.
There is no ban on these kind of products, gloves, etc., which
gloves
are used in medical also. Yeah,
no,
they are not under the ban.
Yeah,
even in the food processing industry, like we said for the shark cap also.
Please request for silence. If you are going to hear the speakers, if you talk amongst yourselves, then we are not going to get anywhere.
The lady, give the
mic this side, please.
I would like to ask one question.
Yes, please. Where
Can
is
I ask
the mic, please? Where is the mic, ma'am?
I wanted to ask.
There's
a post. I wanted to ask a question.
1 second. Let me just finish.
There is 1 minute, sir. You have the mic over there, sir. Will you please kindly give to the lady here, because she's been waiting for a long time. Thank you.
Thank you, Indrani ji.
Yes.
This is Bela from the
Times
of...
Can you please bring it louder?
This is Bela from the Times of India newspaper. Thank you for attending to my question. Nidhi ji has been very kind. She has actually posted the list of items which are banned and which are not banned on her Twitter account. But if you notice, this is one question which is going to unfold drastically after the ban is enforced on Saturday. Common people like you and me and anybody in this room will not be able to go and buy meat or fish from the market. You will not be able to go to your dairy, your local dairy, and buy milk. You will have to buy packaged products which are coming from manufacturers. Manufacturers are allowed to package in plastic bags. Your neighborhood retailer, your neighborhood tabela is not allowed to sell milk in plastic bags. Your neighborhood doodhwala is not allowed to package milk for you. You are supposed to carry steel vessels to the market to buy milk and to buy fish. I want to know how optimum this is. And this is drastic. So if we have
Thank
a solution
you.
From
so
Nidhiji, it would be very good.
This question has been coming very often, ki, what to do when we go to buy fish or meat or chicken.
Yes.
I am, although a vegetarian, but I ask always the questioner whether you or your generations became non-vegetarian in past 25, 30 years. That's not the case. We have been eating fish, chicken, mutton for a very, very long time. And there were alternatives. Our grandparents know about it. Our parents know about it. Just that we have, in past 20, 30 years, the consumerism has increased to such an extent that we actually just want to take that one carry bag, throw it away immediately after the meat or is put in. Besides, like I'm just coming to the next point. There are materials available. There are materials made up of recycled plastic also, which are also available in market. There are materials available of cloth, canvas, which can be cleaned. So you bring it. You need to do some hard work.
Nidhiji, you obviously don't know about milk, meat, and fish.
Yeah, no, I'm not asking on milk. I'm just asking on telling on that fish and meat, etc.
I am a 100% meat eater. I am 100% meat eater from day one, I would say. I also carry two tiffin. Like, I'll just take the example. I also carry a vessel and also like cloth bag. So normally cup parade I used to get. I go personally since I don't believe in my drivers or chipai. So I personally go for a mutton shop, carry a two. If I want to have a fish, I'll carry my vessel. So there is a change of
yes, change of
mindset.
My thing is,
what is meat? And as far as retailing is concerned, except milk and particularly meat products, rest is taken care of. Rest is taken care of, like rice, dal, everything, every packaging will be allowed, the clarification issue. Problem is only with the fish and meat products. Then we
may
have
I please so once again request the audience not to speak, because it is impossible for our speakers to clarify.
I would say, ma'am, I would say my personal example. First, 23rd March was Friday.
Yeah.
So Sunday I sent my driver without even I forget. So the corporate, there is a Maharashtra mutton shop. So this guy rolled it in a newspaper. And I was not, no, it was on dining table. We said, like, so it's a mutton. I said, why? He said, you, Tumi is the ban on, na? But from next week, then I used to send a tiffin. 1 liter tiffin. That is only me.
Your heartiest congratulations to you. Sir? Have you dealt with Vada Pav vendors? How are they going to sell their goods? You can't package in newspaper. Your own government says not to use newsprint. It's going to be a dire strait.
One minute.
You should not use.
All right. Just a minute. Please.
I have one question, sir.
1 minute, please. The lady has been waiting for a long time. Post that, please.
Yeah, hi. So I use steel containers for fish and chicken since a long time. So.
Thank you.
I wanted to check with you for the fine when it's at the shop level.
Please.
At the our individual level, at the building level. So when the BMC truck comes to our building to collect our garbage, and if they find plastic, the banned items, how does the building handle it? How will y'all respond? How will y'all fine? Just give a little clarity on that. And also, if we find banned items in our house subsequently, so we use these BMC locations which you have already, the ward-wise. If you could even more publicize it, because a lot of people don't know where it is, more detailed address of where exactly it is, that would help.
We'll just show you the image that has just been tweeted. Mrs. Choudhary, if you want to, we'll just flash. Just a minute, please. I am quite unable to. Our children who are waiting over there are not even speaking. All the adults are talking. How strange is that? This is the image that once the information was received from Mrs. Choudhary this afternoon, we have put it on the map of Mumbai. It is ward-wise and we will publicize it. We are already on Twitter, on Facebook, and it will be on our portal and any other place. So please download. It's very easy to follow because you are able to identify the ward you live in. So bottom line is, get to know your municipality. This is something which we have always propagated. So
I'll just come to the fine aspect. Basically, this 5,000, 10,000 and 25,000, this was given in the Maharashtra
non-biodegradable. Please, I'm appealing once again.
Garbage Control Act. So it was there in 2006 Act, but because the Act Section 9 writes, it is first offence extend to 5,000, second offence extend to 10,000. So accordingly, this was being discretionarily used by the inspectors. But in 2012, the corporation legal committee passed a resolution that it has to be 5,000 for first offence and 10,000 for second offence. So we, this time when the ban came into place, the fresh ban, which was like rather more comprehensive, we decided to have a relook at it. And we send it to the legal committee also to probably categorize it for the citizens so that the inspectors don't interpret it the way they want. So as of now, because that proposal came went before the legal committee of corporation yesterday, it has been referred back. So that means the last resolution that the corporation passed in 2012 remains in force. That means for first offense, even if it is an establishment, even if it is a trader, even if it is an individual, the fine will be 5,000. If you don't pay, there was one question that what if I am not paying, what if I am not having money. Basically, the Act itself provides that an offence can be registered against the person in the criminal code. So there are two courts which are in Mumbai for municipal corporation, the Vile Parle. Regarding your second question, I am coming. We are not giving the authority to the what are those called? Field marshals.
Yeah, no,
cleanup marshals.
Clean-up marshals.
So cleanup marshals are not given this authority, so they cannot fine you if the banned plastic will be there. So it is only the 249 inspectors of market, license and shop and establishment department. So your household garbage bin, we are not going to look into it. Besides, we are not going to enter into any of your houses. This is a promise from our side.
Okay, so that's clarified. I will add one more sentence to what Mrs. Choudhary has added, is that in the households, the societies, for the last 20 years plus, it has always been that you need to separate your waste, and if your waste is mixed and given to the municipality, they have every right, apart from the fining of the society, is not to lift it. So the stink will no be no different from one place to another. So therefore, what we have always said, let us separate our waste and see to it that we give the right things. Are we taking any, we have got so many questions. I think the gentleman there needs to be given once. You do, but it went from there. It's in all fairness, let us give to the gentleman. So let us take one question here and then you may please ask your question.
Sir,
should I respond for this?
Yes, please.
So basically, we are not going to categorize what exactly the category of plastic. Basically, we are going into the category of products. So no matter whether it is made up like a polyethylene or a polypropylene, all the plastic carry bags are going to go. No matter it is made from even a very quality plastic, food grade plastic, even the single use disposable item, they are going to go. So there is no, people should not get into the chemistry of the plastic.
In any case, the common person will not know the chemistry.
Not required.
But the garbage disposal bags need to be properly taken into account. Yes, please.
Sir, I have this black color plastic garbage bag in my hand. Okay, and on this it is printed exclusively for this specific purpose, handling of solid waste. Is this allowed?
If it is compostable, it is allowed. If it is not compostable, it is not allowed.
So that
how
is the whole problem now.
We need to have a CPCB, Central Pollution.
But sir, I'll just finish. Also, when we check, so in the notification it is written, because today the citizens of Mumbai, first thing in the morning what we do is we give the waste. Ma'am, the dustbins are there. We are putting a garbage bag in the dustbin. So the most important part of our day-to-day life is a garbage bag. So you are saying that the notification says only compostable garbage bag is allowed. So the cost is 5 times more than a regular plastic bag. So now every citizen has to pay something extra from their pocket for a garbage bag. So I think the regular black color garbage bag should be allowed. See, or it is saying in the notification that also that compostable bag or material is used for solid waste. There is the word or in the notification. Even I have read the notification.
I would I would suggest basically why there is a compostable bag suggested for nurseries and garbage. Even in case of like mixed waste, even it goes to a dump. And in six months or 7 months, it goes as a compost because it's from an organic source. It's not from an inorganic source. It's from a like plant source, not an organic. It's from a plant source. Typically, for a nursery, we plant almost more than 5 crore, 10 crore plants every year in forest, and also even for a like a plantation like a tomato, also even potato, we use like typically polythene bags. So after the end of that, all these particulates, they disintegrate, they all stay in the soil and they will spoil the fertility of the soil. And here also, all the plastic will leach. They will like leach into the water and they will contaminate the groundwater source.
As per the notification, it is written compostable plastic or material. The word is written or in the notification.
Basically, it's a compostable plastic itself is a misnomer. That's what I told.
Yes.
It's a misnomer. It's a compostable packaging material. Yes. It is has to be from a plant source. Anything which is soluble in water, not degradable. Salt you can put there. But salt is like, you cannot like dump salt in any dump yard. So like there is a lot of a difference between like a soluble paniyat virgalate kai sambandh nahi paniyat virgalate so it may not be compostable. There are a lot of salts it can be soluble in water. Compostable is it has to be a food material for an organic stuff.
So the Dr. Anbalagan, the appeal is that the common thing of waste bags in societies
that will not go away with just today. So therefore, the issue of the societies, which many society managers and office bearers are here, is that what is compostable is not known. That is a fact. Who are the vendors? That is not known. The shops are not storing it. And just now, as I showed you, those bags are being touted as compostable. So we don't know. So this is one huge area which needs clarity there, or restriction, so knowledge, so that the right thing is done. Because till then, if from say 2 days from today, when the date expires, what will happen to the waste? Because all households will land up with no bags. That is something which I think is a huge challenge. And that is for, ultimately the egg will be thrown on the municipality. So appeal to the regulator to figure out how to address this. Because that I know, and quite honestly, the calls will start coming, bombarding, some extent to many of us. So
I would also appeal to whatever citizens. It's like notification has been issued almost 3 months.
I don't know what
notification is issued 3 months back.
Yes.
We are almost completing 3 months. So there were a lot of people in market that, of course, we will also try to get the list, the bona fide, though we will not be able to certify immediately, but at least likely bona fide manufacturers that can enlist.
Yes.
And we will also put in our website.
Excellent.
We will also do that much one can do. And regarding immediately after the 23rd, what exactly need to be done, of course, your response and your concerns, we will take up to the empowered committee.
Thank you so much. So at least that is a great assurance. And yes, if you want to, please put the rider that it has to be segregated waste. Okay, I think our time is coming to an end. I can see many hands going up of the students.
You should pass it on to the students who are waiting
there. Can we have a students asking the question?
Yeah. And I think with the two questions, we should wind up now.
Yes, please give the yes.
Can you state all the alternatives which can be used instead of the items banned?
See, alternatives, we never suggest papers. You cannot use white paper. It's an inked paper. Again, it again comes with nickel, cadmium, lead, whatever colors has it, is again a chemical or a metal. So it has to be a jute, or it has to be a cotton or a compostable material. Secondly, I'll just come. There are certain activities where we can do away with this so much of comfort, like carrying a box or carrying a container. So we should learn to live without plastic at least in 10% of the life. That's what our appeal is.
What you can do is, as far as the alternatives are concerned, all of you, Ms. Choudhary has already
visit our exhibition tomorrow.
NSCI.
It is in Burley, NSCI. Please do come with all your friends from your school, and you can see all kinds of alternative for cutlery,
thermocol
decorative items, for paper bags.
I know that there are that many questions. Quite unfortunately, we may not be able to take all.
But
you can pass it on to other students.
Jute isn't waterproof,
paper,
right?
I think has already been taken. I think this is what you said,
jute,
about them.
But jute isn't waterproof, right?
That's what I'm telling you. There are some activities like we say reuse, recycle, and reduce. And also reduce. Reduce the use of plastic, reduce the use of waste. That's it, we want to say. We cannot completely replace. It's a simple initiative, 10% or 15%, still that has to be measured. What exactly the impact it's going to have, maybe after 6 months, 7 months. It's a small initiative, and we should find a way to live without that particular 10% of comfort. That's it.
Since there are many more questions, we have an appeal that you have all come with the invitation. Your questions, please feel free to send to us, and we will on pass to both the speakers.
Hello, madam.
We will not be able to take everybody's question, but there's a gentleman here who has.
There's one question different from the other question.
You don't have the mic. The mic has been taken. Please let him
ask
one
question.
And you too. So there will be only three questions now taken up. I'm sorry, we won't be able
to
because we'll have to hold.
I have a very quick one. What is the policy on bubble foam wrap? On bubble foam wrap.
That is
bubble foam wrap.
On bubble foam wrap, which is used for packaging, for glassware.
Packing is not
that would be allowed, right?
Okay, that's already answered. Your question,
I have a question. If a layman wants to understand what is the difference between a 50 micron and a normal micron, a 49 or a 39 micron, we will not understand.
Why
as a layman.
Do you want to know? Why all carry bags are under ban?
No, because then when
all carry bags, 50, below 50, above 50, doesn't matter.
Ma'am,
carry bags are under ban.
Irrespective of thickness, irrespective of size, all the carry bags are going to go, all the single use disposable items are going to
and
go.
And what about these shopping bags? These are all plastic.
These are all fine. No?
This is okay.
Yeah.
So
okay.
Carry
and what is this is and not
what
carry
about no shopping bag like basically
I have this bag
that is a plastic,
plastic.
Yes. That's not plastic it's reusable when you're using it 10 number of times no not using once and throwing it in dustbin and
it's a very limited notification.
Just a minute please
last.
And Mr. Dr.
Last.
Chatterjee we will not be able to take a question. I will need to halt.
One last question.
No, last question.
No,
ma'am, I'm sorry. No.
It's about tree plantations because.
No. Tree plantation is a separate.
It's going to be increasing
no,
the use of paper. Then how are we going to support
that? Please, I think a certain amount of self discipline is required, ma'am. So we will need to close the social sanchar at this point of time. I thank you all for being part of this campaign which has started today. Quite honestly, the first interaction, and I have to first compliment and appreciate that this is first public interaction of Mrs. Choudhury with the citizens of Mumbai after she has come into the MCGM. So she has not shirked. I request a certain courtesy from our audience that when we are speaking, others must also be able to hear. So I would request not to cross talk at the back. We thank all of you, but most importantly, I thank our speakers for coming on the platform together, because the regulator and the implementer speaking to all of us makes many things much clearer than all the doubts that we had. Perhaps certain amount of clarity we will go back with after this session. So I would request now the trustees of VCAN to please come forward. I request Mr. Ranganathan to, on our behalf, to present a small memento to Dr. Anil. Well, there is a plastic here. This came with the packaging.
And it is before 2020.
No, that's it.
$5,000 is fine. Day after tomorrow, not today.
May I take the opportunity of presenting on all our behalf to Mrs. Choudhury for being so spontaneous and joining us this evening. I can tell you she has come on short notice, and rarely do officers do that so quickly, and we are very lucky that she didn't get hauled for some other meeting. So thank you, Mrs. Choudhury, especially. Yes, it will come without us. Please join us for some refreshments. I just...